welcome back to BeHookedCrochet.com. I'm your host, Brittany. And in today's video, I'm going to demonstrate how to crochet the Cozy Fringed Cowl. This is a free pattern that's available at Yarnspirations.com, and you can find the link to the pattern in the description below. To complete your cowl, you're going to need one ball of Burnett Super Value Denim Rag Yarn and a size 5.5mm hook. Once you've printed your free pattern from Yarnspirations.com, go to the instructions section, and that's where we're going to begin this tutorial. The first thing that we need to do is create a slip knot, and you want to leave yourself a little bit of a tail so that way we can weave it in later. Place the loop on your hook, and then we want to chain 46. Once you have a total of 46 chains on your hook, then we're ready to begin our pattern. We want to skip the first chain from the hook, which you see right here, and we're going to work in the second chain from the hook. Now you can actually work your stitches into any part of this chain. I'm going to demonstrate by working just in that top loop right there. We want to make a single crochet into that second chain from the hook. Then we'll chain one and skip one chain, which is right here. We made our single crochet here. We're going to skip that chain, and then we're going to single crochet into the next. Chain one, skip one chain, which you can see right here. And then we're going to work a single crochet into the next chain. Chain one again, skip a chain, work into the next. That's our pattern repeat for this first row. Now when you come to the end of the first row, you'll have a total of 45 stitches. That's going to include the chains and the single crochets. So it's always a good idea to make a quick stitch count before moving on to the next row. To begin the second row, we want to chain one and turn our work. And we want to make a single crochet into the first single crochet stitch. So let's have a look at our foundation chain so far. We have a little gap space right here, and on top of that is a chain. So we know that is a chain space. And if we look just over here, we can see the first single crochet. So the easiest way to tell where we first need to work our stitch is to just rotate this up to the top, cover the chain that's on your hook so you don't get that confused, and then you just want to find that first V. So we can see that right here. So that's where we want to make our first single crochet. Next, we want to make a single crochet into the chain space, which I pointed out earlier. then chain one, skip the next stitch, and single crochet into the next chain one space. Chain one, skip a stitch, and single crochet into the next chain space. So what we're doing for this second row is the same that we did for the first row. And we're going to repeat this sequence all the way across our row until we've reached the end. Now when you've reached the end of your row, we want to make sure we make one single crochet into the very last stitch. And this stitch is a little bit difficult to see sometimes. You want to make sure you don't miss it, otherwise your edges are going to be uneven. So turning your work so that you can look at it from the top and see the V will tell you exactly where you need to work your last single crochet stitch. To begin the third row, we want to chain one and turn our work. And we want to make a single crochet into the first single crochet. This is exactly what we did in the previous row. So locating that first stitch, just want to find that first V, which you can see right there, and work your single crochet into that stitch. Now we're going to chain one, skip the next stitch, and work a single crochet into the chain one space. Chain one, skip a stitch, work the single crochet into the next chain one space. And then we're just going to repeat. When you've come to the end of the third row and you just have two single crochets remaining, and we've ended on a single crochet here, we're just going to continue in the pattern. We want to make a chain one, we'll skip one of those single crochets, and then we'll make a single crochet into the very last stitch. Now moving forward, what we want to do is just repeat the last two rows that we completed. So on your pattern, the first section under the instructions, we're going to repeat the second row and the third row. And we want to do that until it measures about 6 inches from the very start here where our foundation chain was until it measures 6 inches up here. And when you end on your 6 inches, you want to make sure that you have ended on a second row. Once you've completed that step, come back to this video and we'll start on the next section of our cowls. Okay, so when we left off, we needed to crochet our cowls until the repeat that we were working on was about 6 inches from the bottom to the top. So just to reiterate, this pattern is broken into 3 sections. We did the first section, which is what you see here. And now we're moving on to the second section in the written instructions, and that's labeled as the increased point. So you want to direct your attention to the instructions and find the heading that says increased point, first row. That's what we're going to pick up right now. So to begin the first row, we're going to chain one and turn our work. And the pattern that we're going to be working here is very similar to what we were doing in the first section, but as the name implies, we're going to be increasing. So that means we're going to add some extra stitches. So under the first row, it says we need to chain one, which we already did, and two single crochets into the first single crochet. So looking at it from this angle, you can see the first stitch that we need to work into is this little gap, or you can turn it up and you can see the V that we need to work into. So we want to make two single crochets into that stitch. Next, the instructions say to chain one, skip the next stitch, so we're skipping that stitch right here, and then the next stitch should be a chain, so the chain gap, and we're very familiar with working our single crochets in the chain gap from the first section, and we're just going to continue along in that fashion for the first row. So we've made our chain one, we're skipping a stitch, and then we'll make a single crochet into that chain one space, then we're going to chain one again, skip the next stitch, the single crochet we're skipping, and then you'll single crochet into the next chain gap space. And we're just going to repeat this until we've reached the end of the row. So when we've reached the end of the row, we want to pay close attention to the written instructions. It says that we need to repeat that sequence, which is the single crochet and the chain one, to the last single crochet. So what I've done here is I have my single crochet in my last chain one gap space. I've chained one because that's also part of the repeat. Now it's asking me to make one single crochet into the last single crochet. So I'm skipping this single crochet here, because remember this row below is where we started with two single crochets. So I'm going to make a single crochet into the last stitch there, and that's going to finish off the first row. Now moving along to the second row, we're going to chain one, turn our work. And next it says that we want to make one single crochet into the first single crochet. So I'm just going to find that first stitch here, or looking at it from the V, and make a single crochet. And now it says I should make one single crochet into the next chain one space, which if you lift your work up there, you can see that chain one space. So we're just going to make a single crochet there as well. Now we're going to start our usual repeat. We're going to chain one, skip the next single crochet stitch, and single crochet into the next chain one gap space. And we just want to repeat that sequence until we've reached the other side. So when reaching the end of row two, again, we want to pay close attention to the instructions here at the end. So it says that we should repeat the sequence where we did a single crochet and a chain one until we reach the last single crochet, and we want to make a single crochet into the last stitch. So we want to make sure we have that chain one because, again, that's part of the repeat there that's within the asterisk portion of the pattern. And we want to find our very last single crochet. So I've chained one, I'm skipping a single crochet right here, and then I'm going to make a single crochet into the last stitch, which you can see right here where that V is. And that finishes off the second row for this part of the pattern. Now moving along to row three, or the third row, in the second part of this pattern, we need to chain one and turn our work. Now it says that we need to make a single crochet into the first stitch, or the first single crochet. And then we're going to chain one. And it says to make a single crochet into the first chain one space, which is right here. Now we're going to start our usual repeat. So we'll do a chain one, we'll skip a stitch, and we'll work a single crochet into the next chain one space. And just repeat that until we've reached the end of the row. Once you've reached the end of the row, again, let's pay close attention to what the instructions say at the end of the third row, because this part can get a little bit tricky, and if you're unfamiliar with reading patterns, then you might run into some issues with these increases and decreases. So we notice that it says that we need to repeat from the star, or from the asterisk, to the last two single crochets. And if we backtrack just a little bit, where it says the last part of the directions. The last part says one single crochet into the next chain one space. And that's what you can see that I've done here. I have one single crochet into the chain two space, and I did that until the last two single crochets. So you can see I've got one stitch here and one stitch here. So I know that I'm on the right track just from paying close attention to what the instructions tell me to do. So now it says that I need to chain one, and then it says to skip the next single crochet. So I'm skipping this stitch right here, that V all together, I'm just going to skip it. And then it says to make one single crochet into the last stitch. And so we'll do that, and that finishes off the third row. Now we just have one more row for this section in the repeat. Now moving on to the fourth row, we want to chain one and turn our work. And it says to make one single crochet into the first single crochet. So we're pretty familiar with this. We're just going to find the first stitch and make a single crochet. Now it says to make one single crochet into the next chain one space. So you know you're on the right track if the next spot that you have to work into is a chain one space. And we just want to make a single crochet into that space. And now we're going to start our usual repeat. We want to chain one, we'll skip the next single crochet, and we'll make a single crochet into the next chain one space. And then we'll just repeat until we reach the end of the row. So when you make it to the end of the fourth row, what we need to do is just pay close attention to the instructions. And inside those stars in the pattern, it has our usual repeat. And the last part of the repeat is to make a single crochet into the first chain one space. And so when we're ending at the end of a row, we want to make sure that we just follow that last step. So I know we're tempted to go ahead and make a chain one because that's the repeat that we've been working on, but that's not how this particular repeat ends. So we're ending on a single crochet, and it says We're repeating to the last single crochet and then one single crochet into the last single crochet. So I'm almost there. I wanted to point this out because it's a little easy to overlook this chain one space that's in between the last two single crochets. So technically here, I'm not quite done with my pattern repeat. So I'm going to chain one. I'm going to make a single crochet into the last chain one space. I'm not going to make a chain here, and I'm just going to make a single crochet into the very last stitch. Now that finishes off row number four. So now we've fully covered the pattern repeat for this second part, or the increasing point in our cowls. So the instructions tell us now that we need to repeat the last four rows five more times. So everything that we just covered in the last few minutes of this video, the first row through the fourth row, we're going to repeat that five more times. And at the end of those five times, we're going to have a total of 57 stitches. So that's one way you can tell that you're on the right track. The other thing that I recommend doing, because I feel like it's a little bit easier to keep track of your number of rows, is to use these stitch markers to mark the first row every single time around. That way, when you mark the first row, you can go through your fourth rows, and say you have to place your project down for a minute, then you can pick it up and you can just count, you know, oh, okay, well, I'm on the third row here, just because I can count up from the stitch marker, instead of having to differentiate between the different rows once you have, say, three repeats on there. It's gonna get a little bit harder to determine what row that you're actually on. So just to quickly demonstrate what I'm talking about here and how I'm personally going to mark my row so that I can keep track of where I'm at. I'm starting now all over again. I'm starting on the first row because we went through rows one through four in the video. So I'm going to chain one to start off the first row. And then I'm going to take my stitch marker and just place it in that chain. And you don't have to have these fancy stitch markers. If you have them on hand, they work really well. But if you don't, you can use a bobby pin or a scrap piece of yarn, pretty much anything that you can kind of put in the stitch and keep in place. That way you don't lose track of where you are. And so then all I would do is just turn my work and continue on with the first row pattern. So that's what I need you to do at this point. Go ahead and finish crocheting rows 1 through 4 in this increasing portion of the pattern five more times. And then come back to this video. We'll move on to the next section, which is where we begin to decrease. So off camera, what I've done here is I have finished crocheting the increasing point of the pattern. And I mentioned before that I was going to be using these stitch markers to help me keep track of how many repeats I was doing so that I knew when I needed to stop. So now we're going to move on to the decrease point in our written instructions. To begin the first row in the decrease point in the written instructions, we just want to start by chaining one and turning our work. And since we're decreasing here, we're going to be working with single crochet two together. So if you're unfamiliar with that stitch, you just want to follow along with the pattern. After we've made our chain one, we're going to draw up a loop into each of the next two stitches. So we're going to grab that first stitch, insert our hook, draw up a loop. And then we're going to insert our hook into the next stitch, yarn over, and pull up a loop. And now we'll yarn over and pull through all three loops. So what we've done there is we've turned this single crochet and this single crochet stitch into one. Now to continue along, we just want to chain one. We're going to skip the next single crochet stitch. Now we're going to continue by making a single crochet into the chain one space that's right next to the stitch we just completed. And now we can start our repeat. We're going to chain one, skip a stitch, single crochet into the next chain space. And we're just going to repeat that until we reach the end of this row. Now once you've reached the end of your row, you're going to end up with a single crochet in your last chain one space. You'll make a chain, and then we're going to skip this single crochet here, and we're going to make a single crochet into the last stitch. And that's going to finish off the first row in this section. You want to make sure that you're keeping track of your number of stitches. If you look at the end of this row on the instructions, we should have a total of 56 stitches. And that's something you want to keep track of so you make sure that you're making your cowl correctly. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use a stitch marker just like I did before. That way I can keep track of how many repeats I'm doing. Just makes it easier than trying to count them when you can just see them on the stitch marker. Now moving on to the second row, we just want to chain one and turn our work. And we want to make a single crochet into the first stitch there. And then we're going to single crochet into the chain one space right next to it. Now we're going to start our repeat where we chain one, skip a stitch, and work into the next gap space. And we're going to do that until we've reached the other side. Once you've reached the end of the second row, when you have a remaining of two single crochet stitches left, I've ended here on a single crochet in a chain one space, and then instructions say that we should chain one, skip a stitch, and then single crochet into the last stitch. And that is going to finish off the second row. To begin the third row, we want to chain one and turn our work. And we're going to decrease again. So we're going to make a single crochet two together using this first single crochet stitch and the chain one gap space there. So first just insert your hook into the first stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop. Then insert your hook into the chain one gap space, yarn over and pull up a loop, and then yarn over and pull through all three. Now we can start our usual repeat. Chain one, skip the next stitch, and single crochet into the next space. Now, since this is another decreasing row, we're going to end up with a total of 55 stitches at the end of this row. And when you've made it to the end of the third row, we're going to end very similarly to how we have been working this. So we have our single crochet stitch in the chain one space. We're going to chain one, skip a stitch, and then make a single crochet into the last single crochet there. And that'll finish off the third row. Now we have just one more row to cover in this third section of the pattern. For the fourth row, we're going to chain one and turn our work. And we're going to single crochet into the first stitch. And then we're going to single crochet into this next chain gap space. And then we're going to start our repeat. So chain one, skip a stitch, single crochet into the next. And repeat that until we reach the other side. At the end of the fourth row, we're going to end with a single crochet in that last chain one gap space. And then instead of chaining one, we're going to go ahead and make a single crochet into the very last stitch. And now that finishes off the repeat for the decrease point in our cows. So all you need to do at this point is repeat the last four rows five more times. So just like we did when we were increasing. So just to remind you, what I'm going to be doing here is when I start my first row again, I have my stitch markers that I'm just going to place in that chain one, just to remind me that this is the first row of my next repeat. So instead of having to count back the rows, which can get a little bit difficult, I'm really just going to be counting my stitch markers. And so I need to have a total of six stitch markers, or a total of six repeats of the pattern that we just talked about. So go ahead and finish up the decrease point in our cows, and then we'll move on to the next section. So what I've done off camera is I have finished up the decreasing section of the pattern. So I finished my total of six pattern repeats, so rows one through four, and this is now what it looks like. So this was where I increased, and then if you decreased correctly, then you should have a mirror image, or it should look exactly the same as this side here. So the last thing we need to do before we start finishing things off is to make the section down here where we didn't increase or decrease. We just made this long section that was about 6 inches, and we want to do that on this side. And we're going to use the same part of the pattern that we did here in the beginning. So I'll direct your attention to the instructions, the first row through the third row. So that's going to be the very first part on the pattern. And we're going to repeat that until we have a piece that measures 6 inches, just like we do on this side here. Now the one thing I'm going to do is remove one of these stitch markers, and I'm going to place it in this last stitch here. That's just to help me to measure, so I know this is exactly where I stopped decreasing. And so when I measure, I can do so by using this marker to kind of guide me so that I know where I'm at. So the rest of these stitch markers we can simply remove. So since the pattern says that we need to end on a wrong side, I'll go ahead and translate that for you. We're going to end on a second row. So you need to make sure when you've crocheted up to 6 inches that you have stopped on a second row. And that's going to make sure that our seam will go together perfect and without any issues. So go ahead and take the time to finish crocheting this last section of the cow. We're almost finished, and when you've done that, we're going to sew up the seam and we're going to add on the fringe. So off camera, I have finished crocheting the last part of my cow. So you can see this is the stitch marker where I marked my spot so that I could not increase anymore. And this measures about 6 inches right here. So that's how I know we're good to move on to the next step. So the next step is going to be joining the two ends together. So where we bind it off, and this was our starting chain right here over on this side. So there's a bunch of different ways that we can join these. I'm going to demonstrate two ways that I think are the easiest. One is going to be slip stitching the two sides together. And so in that case, you don't want to bind off yet. So if you haven't done that, if you haven't binded off, then you can go ahead and do this method. It's a little bit quicker and easier, but it is going to show a seam, and I'll demonstrate that as we go on. The next step I'm going to demonstrate is how to use a darning needle to sew the two sides together. And that's going to give you a little bit more of a camouflaged stitch. You're not really going to see the join as much as you will with the slip stitch. So let's move forward with the slip stitch method. So what we need to do to get started is fold our cowls in half, and I have it oriented so that where I bind it off, so my working loop here, is on top. And I'm doing that because we need to crochet in our normal direction, so from this side over. And so to make that happen, I needed to fold it in this way. And I've got my working strand back here. I'm just going to hold on to it. And we're just going to insert our hook into the very first chain. And then we'll make a slip stitch. So pull it through and through the loop on your hook. Now that's going to get it attached. So from here on out, we'll need to insert our hook into the stitch on this side of the cowl and into the starting chain on that side. And you can work this however you want. I'm going to go under both loops of the stitch. You can catch just one if you prefer. And then I'm going to work it into the chain on the opposite side. And then slip stitch. When you come to a section that has a chain one, you can insert your hook into the chain or you can go just directly under it and then work it through the chain in the back. So once you get a few stitches, I wanted to show you what I was talking about earlier, where you can really see the seam when you do the slip stitch method. So catching this from a couple different angles, what we're doing here is we're forming kind of a ridge with the slip stitches. And so you may like that and you may not, because this is going to be a pretty visible seam. But this is the easier and probably the quicker method of the two that I'm going to show. So if you're okay with having this ridge here, which will be at the back of the cowl, then you can go ahead and proceed. Okay, so if you want to sew your cowl together, you'll want to fold it so that you can see both of the edges. It's going to make it a little bit easier for you to sew it together. And I have my side here with my working loop. I haven't bind it off yet. A good general rule of thumb is to cut your tail double the length of what you're going to sew. So you can see I've got my working yarn laid here. And I'm just going to kind of go to the other side and loop it back around. And that's generally where I'll need to cut my tail. So that's how I know I'll have enough room, enough yarn, to completely sew this together. So now what I'm going to do is take the tail that I just cut off, and I'm going to pull it through this working loop. And that's just going to secure it so that you can pull on it and it's not going to pull out your stitches. Now you'll just need to thread your darning needle, and since the working yarn is coming from this side, then I'm just going to insert my needle into the other side there, just right in the corner, and pull it back. Now there's a couple of different stitches that you can use when you're sewing it up together, and I typically like to go back and forth. So I worked in this direction just now. When I come back, I'm going to work in this direction and then go that way. And that's going to conceal the stitches a little bit. So it's going to pull the two ends together. You're not really going to see the stitches from this part of the procedure. So I'm going to catch the very next stitch, and I'm just catching the top loop there, and then working it on the other side and pulling that through. Then catching the next stitch on both sides. And no matter which method you choose, whether it be this or the slip stitch, you want to make sure that you're trying to keep your stitches even. because the last thing you want to do is have an even cowl down here, but then it's kind of off on the other side. Now I have a few stitches done, and you can already see how much less visible this method is. So you can see where you're putting the two together, but it doesn't form that bump or that ridge like using the slip stitch method. Now from here, all that's left to do is weave in this tail. Now finally, the last thing we need to do to finish our cowls is to add the fringe. And the instructions say that we should add the fringe to the point of our cowl. So I've got it folded here so that just that surface is showing. And that's so I know where I need to add my fringe. Then what we need to do is make cuts of yarn that are 24 inches. And each tassel is going to be made up of just two strands that are 24 inches long, and then we're going to fold them in half. And in order to get our tassels to be facing the right direction, then we need to come in from the back or the wrong side of the work. So enter your hook in from underneath going out just like this, and then grab your tassel and then place that on your hook and pull it through. Now you can pull that up a little bit just so you can get your fingers in there, and then pull the tail through, and then you'll just pull that tight. And so what I meant earlier by having your tassel facing the right direction is just where that little bar crosses over. So this is what I like to call the right side of the tassel. And alternatively, if you look at it from behind, you have more of like a V or a Y. It's really personal preference. I like the way this looks a little bit better. So basically, all we have to do is make one of those tassels for every single stitch. And so, since these are technically rows rather than stitches, I'm just going to try to make one tassel for every single row. So I'll place my hook into the next row, take my other cut of yarn, and then we'll just continue to work up the side, and then we'll come back and work over there, and then our cowls are going to be finished. So go ahead and finish up your tassels, and we'll meet back up and we'll talk about the end of this project. Once you've completed adding all of your fringe to the pointed edge on our cowls, all that's left to do is fold in the top. And that's it. Our cowls are completed. Now this is totally optional. You don't have to fold it in. You could wear it so that it's scrunched down a bit too, so it'll be a little extra warmth there. This concludes our video demonstration on the Cozy Fringed Cowl, a sponsored project by Yarnspirations.com.